وكذلك مع أولاده وزوجته وكل المجتمع الذي هو فيه.
And also his children, his wife, and the society that he is in.
فإذا حكمنا الشريعة في كل أمور الحياة لا نحتاج أصلا إلى قضاء. لو كل واحد منا عرف الذي له والذي عليه لا نحتاج إلى قضاء. لكن الإشكال كل الإشكال عندما لا تطبق الشريعة. نحتاج إلى من يلزم هؤلاء بتطبيق الشريعة. نعم.
So if every single one of us was to implement the Sharia and apply the Sharia or the rules of Allah, then we wouldn't need judges or Islamic courts. Because when people, or when every single one of us, when each of us doesn't apply the rules and the Sharia and implement the Sharia of Allah, then we need other people, either judges and the courts, to force people to then implement apply the Sharia of Allah.
هل حاجة الناس اليوم للقضاء مثل حاجة الناس أيام السلف الصالح؟ لا. كل ما بعد الناس عن الشريعة كل ما احتاجوا إلى من يلزمهم بتطبيقها. نعم.
Is the need of the people today for judges and courts like the need of the people previously at the time of the Salaf? No. In every instance or in every time whereby people they distance themselves or they go farther away from the Sharia of Allah, then they are in more need of people who will come and oblige and force them to implement and apply the Sharia of Allah.
نعم. هذا ما يتعلق بهذا الناقض ولا بد أن نحكم الشريعة.
So therefore, this is what relates to this matter which invalidates a person's Islam, and we have to implement the Sharia.
يبدأ الإنسان بالعمل قبل أن يقع في الاعتقاد. على ما ذكرنا في الهدي كذلك نذكر في الحكم. نعم.
So a person has to begin by implementing this in his actions before he starts going back to his beliefs. And the same thing which we have mentioned regarding the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we mentioned the same thing about the rules and the laws of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
فلا بد أن نقف عند حدود الله.
So therefore, we have to stop or we have to limit ourselves according to the laws and the boundaries and the limits of Allah.
Abu Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. Abu Mas'ud وهو غير ابن مسعود رضي الله عنهم.
Abu Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, and he is other than Ibn Mas'ud, the companion رضي الله عنه.
يقول كنت أضرب غلام لي.
He says that I used to hit a servant of mine.
يعني عبد مملوك.
Meaning a slave that he used to own.
فسمعت صوتا من خلفي.
So then I heard a voice from behind me.
يعني هناك من كان من خلفه يقول له.
Meaning there was somebody who was behind him and he said to him.
لله أقدر عليك من قدرتك على هذا.
That Allah has more ability over you than your ability over this slave. Meaning Allah has more ability and more control over you than the control and the ability you have over your slave.
قال فالتفت فإذا هو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So Abu Mas'ud رضي الله عنه says, I turn around and it is the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من الذي يذكر الآن بالله؟ النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Who is the one who is now reminding him of Allah? It is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
والصحابة رضي الله عليهم كانوا يقفوا عند حدود الله.
And the companions, they would stop at the rules, the laws, the limits of Allah.
لم يعترض.
They never opposed.
أو يقول يا رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام هو صنع كذا وكذا وكذا.
And they would never say, or he never said that, oh Messenger of Allah, this slave he did this and he did this and he did this.
مجرد أن سمع هذا التذكير من النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
As soon as he heard this reminder from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال يا رسول الله هو حر لوجه الله.
He said, oh Messenger of Allah, this person is free for the sake of Allah.
إذن.
And therefore.
تطبيق الشريعة.
Implementing the Sharia.
يكون على كل أحد.
It is upon every single individual.
نعم. بعد هذا.
And then after this,
بالناقض الخامس من نواقض الإسلام. نعم.
And after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned the fifth matter which invalidates a person's Islam. فقال.
نعم.
So he said, رحمه الله, fifth, if a person hates or detests anything which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with, even if the person performs the action, such a person has disbelieved.
يقول من أبغض شيئا أبغض شيئا شيئا هنا تعم كل شيء قليل أو كثير.
So the author rahimahullah he said that whomsoever hates or detests anything, and anything meaning everything, whether it's little or large.
مما جاء به النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أي من الشريعة كاملة.
From that which the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with, meaning from all of the شريعة.
ولو كان يعمل بهذا الشيء فهو كافر كفر أكبر نسأل الله السلامة والعافية.
Even if a person does this action or performs this action, then a person has committed major disbelief. He's a kafir.
مثال هذا.
An example of this is
يبغض الصلاة.
That a person he detests or hates the prayer.
ولو كان يصلي وهو مبغض للصلاة فهو كافر كفر أكبر نسأل الله السلامة والعافية.
So even if a person prays and yet he hates or detests the prayer, then this person is a disbeliever who has committed a major form of disbelief, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
لأن
because
المحبة
because loving
تكون للعمل والعامل والأزمنة والأمكنة.
Because the love that a person has to be for the action, for the person who does the action, for the time and the place.
والبغض يكون للعمل والعامل والأزمنة والأمكنة.
And also hatred has to be for the action and the person who performs the action and the time and the place.
يحب العمل.
A person loves an action.
كل ما جاءت به الشريعة لابد أن يحب كل ما جاء أو أمر به الله سبحانه وتعالى أو أمر به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلا وربك لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا لا قليل أو كثير مما قضيت ويسلم وتسليما. نعم.
So a person has to love every single action in the Sharia, meaning every single action which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with, or every single action or order which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered with. Like Allah says in the Quran, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ. No, by Allah. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They do not believe حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ. They do not believe up until they make you as a judge, i.e. you, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as a judge in those things which they differ in. And after, the meaning of the ayah is that after the judge, the ruling of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been passed, فَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا
ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُونَ.
Then they do not feel in their hearts any form of haraj, meaning any form of haraj, sajad, any form of displeasure or any form of restriction in their heart.
لا قليل ولا كثير.
A little amount or a lot.
إذن لابد من محبة العمل أي محبة كل ما جاء في الشريعة.
And therefore, from what the Sheikh mentioned, that loving the action, meaning that you love every single thing which the Sharia came with.
ويقابل هذا كل ما حرم الشارع لا بد من بغضه.
And the opposite to this is that everything which the Sharia, meaning Allah Subhanahu wa Taala or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, everything that they have made impermissible, then you have to detest and hate this.
الشارع هو الله سبحانه وتعالى والنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام مبلغ عن الله. نعم.
So the meaning of شارع, either one who legislates, is as I mentioned, Allah or His Messenger or the one who conveys anything from Allah and His Messenger.
نعم. يبغض الشرك.
So a person has to hate and detest الشرك.
والربا.
And also riba, usury and interest.
والزنا وغير هذا من المحرمات.
And zina, adultery, and all those other things which are impermissible.
يحب كل ما أمر به الشارع الحكيم سبحانه وتعالى.
So a person has to love everything which the legislator, i.e. Allah and His Messenger, in their wisdom, they ordered with or they legislated.
الصلاة والصيام والحج والزكاة وغير هذا.
Prayer, fasting, الزكاة, حج, and other than these matters.
الثاني محبة العمل العامل.
And then the second thing is a person loving the person who performs the action.
الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
The messengers and the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
الملائكة.
The angels.
الصالحين.
The righteous people.
كل موحد يحب ولا بد في الله.
Every single person who is upon التوحيد. Every single person who is upon التوحيد, he has to be loved.
بغض.
And at the same time hating.
للعامل.
The person forms an action.
إبليس.
For example, إبليس.
كفار.
The disbelievers.
أهل النفاق. نسأل السلام والعافية.
The people of hypocrisy, we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
كل كافر.
Every disbeliever.
محبة أزمنة يحبها الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And also loving those times which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves.
ثلث الليل الآخر.
For example, loving the last third of the night.
ليلة القدر.
The night of Al-Qadr.
رمضان.
Loving Ramadan.
وغير هذا.
And the other times.
بغض أزمنة.
And also hating certain times.
يحتفل بالكفار مثلا بأعيادهم كعيد رأس السنة.
So for example, hating the times or the festivals that the non-Muslims and the disbelievers celebrate, such as the New Year.
محبة أمكنة يحبها الله.
And also loving those places which Allah loves.
المساجد.
The mosques.
مكة.
مكة.
المدينة.
مدينة.
وغير هذا.
And other places.
بغض أمكنة.
And also hating certain places.
يبغضها الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Those places which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates and detests.
أماكن الشرك.
The places of shirk.
والمعاصي.
The places of disobedience.
مسجد ضرار.
A masjid that was built in order to harm the Muslims.
نعم. وغير هذا.
And other places that Allah
إذن هذا الناقض في من أبغض الشيء قليل أو كثير.
So therefore this matter, i.e. this naqid, the matter which invalidates Islam, is somebody hating anything, whether it be a large amount, small amount.
قال ولو عمل به كفر كمن أبغض الصلاة وهو محافظ على الصلاة المفروضة. نعم.
So this matter relates to hating anything which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with. If you hate anything which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, even if he performed that action, then this is major disbelief. Like, for example, the person who hates the prayer and yet he observes every single one of his prayers. He prays every single one of his prayers. This person is a disbeliever.
نعم حتى وإن كان هذا البغض للصلاة النافلة للفريضة.
Even if this person he hated the voluntary prayers, not the obligatory prayers.
لأن هذا فيه اعتراض على شرع الله سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
Because this shows a rejection or turning away from the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فلا بد أن تحب الله.
So therefore you have to love Allah.
ولا يمكن أن تحب شيء مع الله.
And it's not possible for you to love anything along with Allah.
وتحب كل من أمر الله بحبه.
And that you love every single person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered for you to love.
عمل.
Or anything such as an action.
وعامل.
Or the person who does the action.
وأزمنة وأمكنة.
Or times or places.
نعم. بعد هذا.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned the sixth matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
هذا الناقض من النواقض التي ذكرنا أن النواقض تجتمع في أربعة أشياء، إما قول أو عمل أو اعتقاد أو شك.
هذا في الاستهزاء.
هذا ناقض عظيم، ويقع فيه بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه، وهو الاستهزاء. نعم.
So this matter which invalidates a person's Islam, the next one that I'm going to read, this is something which many people fall into, and it goes back to an action which invalidates a person's heart, a person's Islam, whether it's a statement or an action or a belief.
No.
So the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, sixth, a person who makes mockery of something which is from the religion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or makes mockery of its rewards or punishments, such a person has disbelieved. Wa dalil qawluhu ta'ala, and the evidence for this is the saying of Allah the Most High, قُلْ say, أَبِاللَّهِ was it at Allah, وَآيَاتِهِ and his signs, and his messenger, that you used to make mockery of? لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا, do not make any excuse, قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, indeed you have disbelieved after your belief and faith.
الاستهزاء سخر واستهزأ ورآه لعبا وليس بجد. نعم هذا هو الاستهزاء.
So
يسخر ويستهزئ يرى أن هذا الشيء ليس بجد بل أنه من اللعب.
So the meaning of istihza, which is the name of this matter, means to mock something or make mockery of something or treat something very very lightly as if it's just some type of play. All of this comes under al-istihza, a mockery.